Wyona drove an average speed of 50 miles per hour from her home to Red Bluff to visit her sister in Cottonwood. She stayed in Cottonwood 38 hours. On the trip back, she averaged 60 miles per hour. She returned home 49 hours after leaving. How many miles is Red Bluff from Cottonwood? So this problem deals with the formula distance equals rate times time. So notice how I set up a table to record all the information that we need. And again, we know that the distance is going to be equal to the rate times the time. We'll complete this table as much as we can for the trip to Cottonwood and then also for the return trip. Notice how we're asked to determine the distance. So let's call the distance to Cottonwood d sub t and the distance from Cottonwood d sub f. Now, even though we're trying to determine the distance from Red Bluff to Cottonwood, we know that these two distances are going to be the same. So d sub t is going to equal d sub f. Now see if we can figure out what the total driving time would be. Notice how she stayed in Cottonwood for 38 hours, and then she returned home 49 hours after leaving. So 49 minus 38, so 49 hours minus 38 hours would be the total driving time. 49 minus 38 is equal to 11. So the total driving time, again, was 49 minus 38, which equals 11 hours. Now we need to be careful because this does not mean that she spent half the time driving to Cottonwood and half of the time driving back. Because notice how her average speed to Cottonwood is less than the average speed of her return trip. So we'll let the time traveled to Cottonwood be represented by the variable x. And since the total driving time is 11 hours, the driving time for the trip from Cottonwood would have to be 11 hours minus x. So if she spent 4 hours driving to Cottonwood, 11 minus 4 would be 7 hours driving from Cottonwood. Now let's look at the rates. For the trip to Cottonwood, she averages 50 miles per hour. And on the trip from Cottonwood, she averages 60 miles per hour. Now we have enough information to solve this problem. We will have to do this in two stages. Since d sub t, the distance to Cottonwood, is equal to d sub f, the distance from Cottonwood, that means 50 times x must equal 60 times 11 minus x. Again, if the distances are the same, then the rate times the time must also be the same. So now we can solve this for x and determine the time spent driving in each direction. And then from that, we can determine the distance from Red Bluff to Cottonwood. So we'll distribute here. We would have 50x equals, this will be 660 minus 60x. Now if we want to solve for x, we have to have x on one side of the equation. So we'll add 60x to both sides. So we have 110x equals 660. Divide both sides by 110, and we have x equals 6. Well, if x equals 6, that means she spent 6 hours driving to Cottonwood, and then 11 minus 6 would be 5, so she spent 5 hours driving from Cottonwood back to Red Bluff. But the question asks us, how many miles is it from Red Bluff to Cottonwood? Since these two distances are equal to each other, it doesn't really matter which equation we use. Let's go and just use the first one, where d sub t does actually represent the distance from Red Bluff to Cottonwood. So d sub t is going to be equal to 50 times 6, which is equal to 300, which means the distance from Red Bluff to Cottonwood is 300 miles. So these types of problems can be challenging. I think it's important to read the question several times to understand exactly what's happening and then organize all the information in a table before we try to draw any conclusions. I hope you found this helpful.